Well, hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I have to tell you that I'm interested in this matchbox after watching a review video from my diecaster friend Mr. Agung Diecaster. He is a diecaster as well as an expert with his stop motion videos with his diecast toys. So subscribe him and enjoy his videos. Yes, this is matchbox 1956 Aston Martin DBR1 with a nice green color. It's a legendary car because of racing history. This sport racing car built by Aston Martin at 1956. Renowned as the 24 Hours of Le Mans 1959 champion in the Endurance Classic. The racing team that used it at that time was the David Brown Racing Department. Aston Martin DBR1 was the only British car that won in the 24 Hours of Le Mans. The shape is unique and aerodynamic. And here is the picture on the car. It was Matchbox City Series number 73 of 100. There is an officially licensed by Aston Martin. Here is the code made in Thailand. It was been released in 2020. Let's open this out. So this is Aston Martin DBR1 1956 car model. Look how handsome this car. The shape is aerodynamic, roadster, and no hardtop. So handsome. The color is metallic green, shiny. The price of this real car cut a record for the most expensive car made in England. In August 2017, it reached the highest price of $22.5 million, or 314 billion rupiah. Wow. Then let's discuss the details. From right side, there are details of ventilation. Look the tires. I noticed that Matchbox has these really cool tires. The rims are metallic silver. Tires and rims are made of plastic, but it's okay because this diecast was so special. There is a small handle detail, round shape. The front window from plastic. There are no mirrors. Next, you will see from the front, there's the Aston Martin logo and there's also a 1214 and the writing on it. The details of the lights are plainly painted white and slimed silver. That is okay for a cheap price because I got it for 21,000 rupiah. But if you find out the history of this car, this diecast is a collectible item. The grille was very cool. The hood of the car is quite long because it contains the engine inside. There are no wiper details. From the right side, like this, there was difference. There is an exhaust with the silver color. Cool, very cool. From the back side, there's a Aston Martin logo as well and 1214 MB. Then there are the details of the tail painted red. Then this is the interior. Right hand wheel. On the seats, there are details of the loose belt. Very nice. Then the chassis was made from the plastic. There is an inscription of 1956 Aston Martin DBR1. Copyright 2019 metal. Made in Thailand, Matchbox trademark. The lower tail is also refined. Yes, this is 1956 Aston Martin DBR1. It was famous as the champion of 24 hours of Le Mans in 1959. In 1957, he won first place in the World Sport Car Championship Season 1 when the driver was Tony Brooks. He also won first place by Tony Brooks and second place by Roy Salvadori in the Spa Sports Car Race. At the same year, this car also won the World Sports Car Championship debut in the fourth round, the 1,000 km Nürburgring by Tony Brooks and Noel Cunningham Rey. In 1959, Aston Martin then completed a hat-trick of victories, again won the 1,000 km Nürburgring with Moss and Jack Fairman driving. In addition to this victory, Aston Martin finally achieved what is considered their finest motorsports triumph. DBR1, driven by Carroll Shelby and Roy Salvadori, took victory at the 1959 24 Hours of Le Mans. DBR1, driven by Maurice Trintignant and Paul Freire, Munich second. The Aston Martin DBR1 was intended for the World Sports Car Championship as well as non-championship sports car race at the time. Well, that was a short review about this diecast from me. If there are additions, please comment below. Thanks for watching. Until next time.